In today's video, I am going to explain three structures around hip muscles that can cause low back pain. I am going to explain two muscles and one connective tissue. First thing first, of course, other muscles which I'm not going to talk about may cause low back pain because low back pain is complicated symptoms. Of course, other muscles can be low back pain caused. But today's structures are highly related for low back pain. Let's get started. First muscle is this one. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius. This is on lateral part of pelvis and hip. What is main function of gluteus medius? That is hip abduction. Abduction. Abduction is like open leg, like sideways. This is main function of gluteus medius. But if you look at me more detail, there are many more functions. See, this is profile view. Imagine this is pelvis, and it's a little bit hard to see. This is gluteus medius. It's like this. If you divide gluteus medius anterior to posterior, you can see anterior fiber and posterior fiber. Anterior fiber does hip flexion. Hip flexion. And posterior fiber does hip extension. Hip extension and hip flexion. Again, when anterior fiber contracts, that also moves pelvis. That is this way. This is anterior tilt. Anterior tilt. The other way is posterior tilt. Main function is abduction. Plus there are other four movements. Flexion, extension, anterior tilt, and posterior tilt. If I go more detail, there are rotational movements, but I will stop at this point. Anyway, five movements. Plus important thing is stability. Stability of hip and pelvis. See, there are many functions in gluteus medius. So when this muscle gets tight, that basically inhibits movement of hip and pelvis. But wait a minute, today's topic is about low back pain. Why am I talking about gluteus medius? Here is the thing. When muscles get tight, joint doesn't move. Right? So when gluteus medius doesn't move, hip joint and pelvis don't move. Yep, these two places don't move. When pelvis don't move, what's gonna happen? What is in between two pelvis, two pelvic bone? There is sacrum. Yeah, sacrum is between pelvis, right? What is above sacrum? That is lumbar spines. Thus, tight hip muscles inhibit movement of pelvis. If pelvis doesn't move, sacrum doesn't move. If sacrum doesn't move, lumbar spine does not move. Do you see this kind of a flow? Hip, pelvis, sacrum, and lumbar spines. That is why movement of hip muscles are so important for tight low back and low back pain. Usually, when joint doesn't move, tendency is there is tightness and pain. See? Gluteus medius. That is why I focus on this muscle a lot for my clinical experience. Number one, gluteus medius. Let's go to number two. Alright, that is this muscle. This is piriformis. Piriformis is also hip muscle. This originates from sacrum. You don't see attachment surface, so I will show you from different picture later, okay? Anyhow, piriformis originates from sacrum, and it inserts to femur. I said that originates from sacrum. Yeah, what happens if piriformis doesn't move? That inhibits movement of hip joint, of course. Then, what's gonna happen? Then that affects for sacral movement, and what is above sacrum? There is lumbar spine. By the way, what is function of piriformis? That is hip abduction. It's like gluteus medius. Plus external rotation. External rotation. Actually, there are other external rotators in hip. Of course, these guys can be cause for low back pain, but I on purposely picked up today. Why? I said, again, piriformis originates from sacrum and that inserts to femur. There are only two muscles that originates from axial skeleton, then cross hip joint. Axial skeleton means lumbar spine, thoracic spine, and sacrum. It's basically spine. Other hip muscles originate from pelvis. Only two muscles originate from axial skeleton. The one muscle is piriformis. By the way, what is the other one? The other one is psoas. Of course, psoas can be a cause for low back pain, but I will try to talk about psoas for another video. Anyhow, piriformis originates from sacrum. When this muscle gets tight, sacrum doesn't move, then lumbar spine doesn't move. Now, let me show you from different picture. This is anterior view. Where is piriformis? That's here. This is piriformis, and this is sacrum. And you don't see edge of sacrum right here. You don't see that, right? That is why, that is kind of proof piriformis originates from anterior surface of sacrum. Usually, when you look at anatomy book, that picture looks like piriformis originates from lateral edge of sacrum, but it's not. It's actually from anterior surface of sacrum. Having this visualization is going to be very important. Maybe you can apply this anatomy for stretching, yoga, Pilates, weight training, athletic performance, many things. Having visualization of anatomy, freaking important. Alright, this is number two. Number two is piriformis. Then what is number three? Actually, it is connective tissue. This is again profile view. This is where pelvis is. I want to talk about this one, this connective tissue. This is iliotibial band. Iliotibial band is part of thigh fascia. Iliotibial band is the thickest part of thigh fascia. So imagine there's fascia wrapping around thigh. Again, iliotibial band is the thickest place in fascia of thigh. This fascia attaches to pelvis and it goes to tibia. Why? Because it's iliotibial band. That's from pelvis to tibia. What happens if fascia gets tight? This fascia goes to pelvis. Thus, tightness of this fascia may inhibit movement of pelvis. Yeah, movement of pelvis is gonna be inhibited. Then what's gonna happen? If pelvis doesn't move, which one doesn't move? Sacrum doesn't move. If sacrum doesn't move, lumbar spines do not move. So basically, the connective tissues, fascia and muscles around pelvis inhibit lumbar spines. This complex, hip joint, pelvis, sacrum, lumbar spine, this complex is very, very important. It is all connected. It is all united. You should not separate anatomy like one by one. Of course, it's easy to memorize muscle and bone one by one. It's a good way to remember at first time. But as you build the knowledge of anatomy, now try to unite all the knowledge you have. And you can analyze human body from different angle. That is why study anatomy is very important, have basis for your career. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.